Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise be unto God, our Father. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we are so grateful and so appreciative to God for all of the wonderful things that he's doing in our midst. I thank God for you on today. I thank God that you tuned us in on today because I know the Lord has a word just for you. And he is moving by his Spirit. He's healing. He's delivering. He's working miracles, and I believe that he has a miracle with your name on it today. You didn't tune in by accident or coincidence. It's divine providence. Oh, thank God for you, and I'm praying that the Lord will move on your life mightily. And whatever you need, he will provide. So we're going to invite you to come on in, go with us into the service that is already in progress, and I know you're going to be blessed. Thank God. Let us go.
I'm going to ask you to get your Bibles and come along with me to Proverbs. We're going in the Old Testament. Is that all right?
Yes, that's right.
We're going to Proverbs, chapter 16. And my topic on tonight is commit your works unto the Lord.
All right.
Commit.
That's right.
Proverbs 16, verse 3. Everybody have it? It says, commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. Why is God telling us to commit? Why should we commit? Well, I'm saved, I'm born again, but we're not committed. Well, I didn't come to hurt your feelings, I came to tell the truth. Okay?
Help us.
So commit means to dedicate yourself, to allow yourself. When you commit to something, you make a decision to say that I'm going to do this thing. I'm going to stay here.
Amen.
You commit to a marriage. You commit to raising your children. You commit to what the boss say on the job.
Amen.
Now God is saying, I want you to come up higher and commit to me.
Yeah.
Well, I'm saved. I committed to Jesus. That's not enough. That guaranteed your salvation in the kingdom or your eternal life. But after you made that step, you have to commit your life to God. And that is an everyday challenge.
Yeah.
It is a lifestyle change.
Yeah. All right.
So what is God saying? I want you to commit your actions to me.
Yeah.
I died on the cross for you.
Yeah.
I called my blood caused your name to be written in heaven. So first, you owe me.
Hallelujah.
And I want you to commit to me. I don't want you to forget what I did for you.
All right now, help.
Because my blood signed your name on the wall.
Okay.
So first of all, you owe me.
Oh,
that's why you need to commit.
Yes, Lord.
So when we keep that in remembrance, it'll help us.
Yeah.
Why? Because different things come our way. Why should I commit? Because God said so.
Mm-hmm.
Commit is an action word. It's something that you do constantly.
Mm-hmm.
So don't think, well, okay, I committed, I joined the choir, I'm on the usher board now. I'm committed as the musician. I'm commit. No, that's not enough. You committed to coming to church, but I want you to commit a little bit further. What is he saying? I want you to carry out this for me. So when you're doing this, you do it to me because I want you to do it to me. When I say me, I'm talking about the Lord Jesus Christ. I want you to change your lifestyle for me. I want you to put everything on the altar for me. I want you to change this year. Because the only way you're going to go up is down on your knees or laying out before God. That's how you're going to go up this year, church. We've been praying and we've been getting through, but God said, I'm going to challenge you this year. I want you on your knees and I want you laying before me. And I'm not just asking you to do this at church. I want you to do it at home. Because, see, when we come to church, we come together. We gather together to worship, to praise, to learn the word of God. But when you go out the door, I want to see some evidence now. I want some proof. So why? God is saying, because you committed to me, I want to see something different. Now, as I'm telling you this, God is challenging me too. So as I preach to others, I preach to myself. He says also, I want you to obligate yourself. I want you to come up higher. Because I'm not pleased with what you, where you are and what you're doing right now. It's not enough. Well, how do you know it's not enough? Has God been good to you? Has God been good to you? Have you been good to God? Now ask yourself that question. How good have you been to God? All you have to do is watch your walk. I don't have to find out what you did and didn't do. You can judge yourself and know. As good as God has been to us, you know we got to fill up. You know we got to line up with this world, church. So what he says, commit your works. I want your lifestyle. I want your mind. I want you to dedicate your mind. I want you to renew your mind. There's a great work that has to be done in this ministry. And you have to change the way you think about church for you to get the souls to come in. You got to change the way you think about God. You think about apostle and his wife. You have to change the way you think. This is your church. Do you want
to? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Wasn't that a powerful service? Did you not you feel the presence of the Lord in our midst? Oh, I just thank God for what he is doing and what he did. And I know that you were excited and you felt the presence of the Lord. And I pray that you have made a decision to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And if you have not, I'm praying for you that today would be the day that you would make a decision to walk with Jesus both now and throughout eternity. God loves you and he wants you to be a part of his family. And now I ask you to stay tuned, and our announcer is coming with more information that's going to help you to be able to receive and do the things that you want to do from this time forward. Praise God and wait on our announcer. Here she comes.
Thank you for watching the Healing Word Ministries. We pray that something was said to encourage, inspire, and enlighten you in your fellowship with the Lord. If you are in the Memphis, Tennessee, or the West Memphis, Arkansas area, we invite you to come and fellowship with us. We are at the Word on the Move Tabernacle, located at 2703 East Broadway in West Memphis, Arkansas. Our service times are as follows. On Sunday, we have special Bible teaching school at 9:30 a.m., and at 11 a.m. is our morning worship. On Thursday evenings at 6:30 p.m., we have prayer, praise, and kingdom teaching. If you desire the message in its entirety, please contact us at the Healing Word Ministries, P.O. Box 1173, West Memphis, Arkansas, 72303. Or you can call us at area code 870-394-4596. Visit our website at www.thewordonthemove.com. Our motto here is, the decision you make today determines the future you create. May God bless you.